Coach, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on the win tonight. This is the first comeback win for the boys in terms of being down to half the entire season. How are you feeling about the way your guys played tonight?
We wasn't particularly happy with our first half. We was really unfortunate to concede the goal how we did. And no blame's put on any of the players. That's just how we want to play. So I'll take full responsibility for that again. Just really unlucky with how it sort of popped up on the turf with Jeff. But no blame on him. I thought he was brilliant tonight. So, no, it was just a case of getting him in at half-time, speaking about how we win the game. And we felt like they had quite a high line. And we felt like balls in their box would cause them a lot of problems. I have to say the finishes were exceptional. I was really happy with the comeback and the character from the players. It would have been very easy to chuck it in.
This has been quite a season for Juan Carlos Obregon. It's his 10th goal for the club tonight. He scored in three straight, continues to expand on that single season record with every goal. What can you say about the way he's played this year?
Yeah, he's been magnificent. And I think, in fairness, he could have had a couple more tonight. But JC is always there or thereabouts. He's such a pest to the opposition. And his work rate gets him, it gets him the goals. But I also think we have to give credit to the players that were supplying him as well. We had, one or two brilliant crosses to attack. But the finish tonight was a proper finish. He really meant it. Went across the line of the ball, powered through it. You heard it hit the net. It was an emphatic goal.
Speaking of proper finishes, we have to talk about Connor. Another incredible goal from Connor. Tell me a little bit about how that kind of came to be and what you guys have done there.
We was really annoyed at halftime that we didn't give it to Connor on the edge of the box because it was on the whole first half. And then you know what he's got. You see it from the first pre-season game. You know what he's got from them areas. He's really dangerous. So it's just important that we get him the ball in them areas. And he's really reliable and he produced a great finish.
I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that this was, I think, the first match this season you've played without your captain, Danny Pereira. What was that? In the first 50 or so minutes, it looked a little bit different and you seemed to kind of struggle to generate, but you guys kind of found it late. Was it tough playing without him at the beginning?
Yeah, I think any team missing Danny would struggle. They would struggle. He's our captain, he's our leader. We would miss him in any game, but I think what the boys did tonight is they made up for it and they showed a lot of character.
And just you speaking about that character, just tell me a little bit more. First time this year winning a match after conceding first time winning after trailing a half, and really, you're eliminated from the playoff contention, but these guys are still fighting. What does that say about them?
Yeah, I just think we've been speaking about it all season about the character and the culture at the club that we've tried to create. And whether you win or lose, that culture is always going to be there. And sometimes it gets tested, but we've got some magnificent people in the building, and I'm people first. But I also have to give credit to the staff at half-time with the information that they gave to the players. And a little special mention to John Stead, who was speaking to the forwards at half-time about those runs across the front, and that comes to fruition in a few of the goals.